Barney by Will Stanton. Place: a desolate island. Plot: a bizarre experiment. Object: to increase the intelligence of a very special rat. August 30th. We are alone on the island now, Barney and I. It was something of a jolt to have to sack Talo after all these years, but I had no alternative. The petty vandalisms I could have forgiven. But when he tried to poison Barney out of simple malice, he was standing in the way of scientific progress. That I cannot condone. I can only believe the attempt was made while under the influence of alcohol. It was so clumsy. The poison container was overturned and a trail of powder led to Barney's dish. Talo's defense was of the flimsiest. He denied it. Who else then? September 2nd. I am taking a calmer view of the Talo affair. The monastic life here must have become too much for him. That, and the abandonment of his precious guinea pigs. He insisted to the last that they were better suited than Barney to my experiments. They were more his speed, I'm afraid. He was an earnest and willing worker, but something of a clod, poor fellow. At last I have complete freedom to carry out my work without the mute reproaches of Talo. I can only ascribe his violent antagonism toward Barney to jealousy. And now that he has gone, how much happier Barney appears to be. I have given him complete run of the place, and what sport it is to observe how his newly awakened intellectual curiosity carries him about. After only 2 weeks of glutamic acid treatments, he has become interested in my library, dragging the books from the shelves, and going over them page by page. I am certain he knows there is some knowledge to be gained from them had he but the key. September 8th. For the past 2 days I have had to keep Barney confined, and how he hates it. I am afraid that when my experiments are completed I shall have to do away with Barney. Ridiculous as it may sound, there is still the possibility that he might be able to communicate his intelligence to others of his kind. However small the chance may be, the risk is too great to ignore. Fortunately there is, in the basement, a vault built with the idea of keeping vermin out, and it will serve equally well to keep Barney in. September 9th. Apparently I have spoken too soon. This morning I let him out to frisk around a bit before commencing a new series of tests. After a quick survey of the room, he returned to his cage, sprang up on the door handle, removed the key with his teeth, and before I could stop him, he was out the window. By the time I reached the yard, I spied him on the coping of the well, and I arrived on the spot only in time to hear the key splash into the water below. I own I am somewhat embarrassed. It is the only key. The door is locked. Some valuable papers are in separate compartments inside the vault. Fortunately, although the well is over 12 meters deep, there are only a few meters of water in the bottom, so the retrieving of the key does not present an insurmountable obstacle. But I must admit Barney has won the first round. September 10th. I have had a rather shaking experience, and once more in a minor clash with Barney I have come off second best. In this instance I will admit he played the hero's role and may have saved my life. In order to facilitate my descent into the well, I knotted a length of 2 centimeter thick rope at half-meter intervals to make a rude ladder. I reached the bottom easily enough, but after only a few minutes of groping for the key, my flashlight gave out and I returned to the surface. A few meters from the top I heard excited squeaks from Barney, and upon obtaining ground level I observed that the rope was almost completely severed. Apparently it had chafed against the edge of the masonry, and the little fellow, perceiving my plight, had been doing his utmost to warn me. I have now replaced that section of rope and arranged some old sacking beneath it to prevent a recurrence of the accident. I have replenished the batteries in my flashlight and am now prepared for the final descent. These few moments I have taken off to give myself a breathing spell and to bring my journal up to date. Perhaps I should fix myself a sandwich, as I may be down there longer than seems likely at the moment. September 11th. Poor Barney is dead, and soon I shall be the same. He was a wonderful rat, and life without him is not worth living. If anybody reads this, please do not disturb anything on the island, but leave it like it is as a shrin to Barney, especially the old well. Do not look for my body, as I will cast myself into the sea. You might bring a couple of young rats and leave them as a living memorial to Barney. Females, no males. I sprained my wrist is why this is written so bad. This is my last will. Do what I say and don't come back to disturb anything after you bring the young rats like I said. Just females. Goodbye.